Despite its likely improved specs, the RTX 40 series could launch at the same price point as its predecessors. Given that, here's what the RTX 40 series could cost. GeForce RTX 4060, $329. GeForce RTX 4070, $499. GeForce RTX 4080, $699. Nvidia is keeping RTX 4000 specs under a well-guarded lock and key, but some key details have managed to slip out. If a number of leaks are to be believed, we could be looking at the following: 12 graphics processing clusters, 18,432 CUDA cores, 96 MB L2 cache, potentially up to 92 teraflops of compute performance, 2,500 MHz clock speed, up to 900 watt. Leaks suggest that graphics cards such as the RTX 4090 and RTX 4080, which will likely use the flagship AD102 GPU die, may feature up to 71% more CUDA cores than RTX 3000. The latest rumors point to the RTX 4090, RTX 4080, and RTX 4070 release date being in September. It's not yet confirmed when Team Green plans to release less powerful and less expensive RTX 4000 GPU like the RTX 4060 and RTX 4050 Ti, but this is very likely more a case of when rather than if. No Nvidia RTX 4000 game or production benchmarks have leaked yet. Nonetheless, leakers claim that graphics cards like the GeForce RTX 4090 could double the performance of the RTX 3090 in both standard rasterization and ray tracing. Graphics card could come equipped with 46 GB GDDR6 VRAM while requiring two 16-pin power connectors. However, ever higher levels of performance require ever higher levels of power draw. This is where the new PCIe Gen 5 interface comes into play, which was first seen on an RTX 3090 during Intel's innovation event. It can provide up to a staggering 600 watt of power to a graphics card, but is also much more compact and less fiddly than the PCIe 8-pin power connectors we've become so accustomed to. Unfortunately, the performance increase offered by high-end RTX 4000 graphics cards may require a hefty and expensive power supply. Reports indicate that components using the AD102 may have a TGP of up to 900 watt.